Hey guys, this is Sunny from Team Ripper Lips. I got the unboxing of the Daiwa Lexa 100 HSL. Alright, let's get this open. There's not much in the box to show you. It's the reel in a bag, and then the manual. Doesn't come with oil, doesn't come with a wrench or a tool or anything like that. So let's put this aside. So basically we got basic info on the reel, how to use the reel, the MagForce brake, turn it off, you know, how to use it, how to engage the cast, how to basically the whole overrun of the reel. Warranty, repairs, and then usually with all reels you get this. You get a breakdown sheet, parts list, shows you all the parts and where they go. So if you want to take your reel apart, it's pretty easy to put back together if you follow the instructions. And just basically all the codes and part numbers of everything that you need if you wanted to replace anything or need a part. So let's see the reel. Here's the reel. Just out of the box, it looks really good. It's got a nice gunmetal color. nice gunmetal gray with that nice sparkle in it, that nice glitter. You can see that. It's got nice chrome accents on the drag. Just a nice looking reel, and it feels really light. It says that it's 8 ounces, but it feels really light. You'd think with these big rubber knobs that and that big handle, you'd think this thing would be really heavy feeling. Doesn't feel that heavy for 8 ounces. That does not feel like 8 ounces. We got a swept aluminum handle, nice rubber knobs. They look really thick and rubbery, but they don't feel like they're really heavy. I actually opened these caps to look into there, and it's pretty hollow in there, and it goes down to the bearings. The bearings don't start till about right about there. So it's not like this whole thing is all filled, and then it has a whole shaft that comes all the way down to here. So they're really short, so I'm pretty sure that saves on weight. And the star drag is very thin for the cap here that covers for the dust. And for the click of the drag is under that, and the aluminum is nice, and it just looks really good, and it's clicking. You will not have clicking on the tension knob. This is just smooth running, standard. It shouldn't adjust on you, but it has a little bit of tension against it. It's not like it's so easy to spin that it's just gonna come loose on you. Got a real nice thumb engage for the cast. Your thumb fits right into it. Your line will be up here, so the heel of your thumb fits right on that. It's just real nice. Really nice wiffle spool. It's got nice gold accents on it, and the spool has very, very light. It's very light. Like with this brake off, I'll shut this off. Make sure the tension knob's loose. And to check to see if it's loose enough, to feel the actual spin of it, you want a little bit of a gap side to side. That's when you know that's not touching. So the spool is very soft. You can just barely touch that and get it going. So, like they say, this reel is supposed to cast light lures very well, and usually it's because of the spool. And it's very soft. I could see this throwing some nice light lures. Anyways, so this has the MagForce brake. I'll show that to you. The best way I found to open this up, instead of using a screwdriver and damaging this all up here, because it's very thin, it's very shallow. I found that a quarter works a lot better than a penny. and it fits into that groove a lot better. I mean, it's not like it's cut, doesn't have a groove very deep, so it's almost the shape of the roundness of this quarter, and it fits right in there perfect to loosen it and to tighten it. It's not like it slips, you know, and wants to strip it out. So this, it won't fall out either when you loosen it. So it's got a spring, and it's pretty secure. It's not gonna just fall out on you. And to open this reel, you want to spin it down, just like that. You just pull that off. Now this has an aluminum frame and an aluminum side plate, and when they say side plate, they don't mean the brake side. This is graphite, which is okay because this is stiff and it's just the carrier bearing for the spool. Most of the flex you're gonna feel is in the reel itself and in the reel foot. If it was a graphite frame or whatever material they would use, so I can see where they would skimp on this for the price point that this is at. And it's still well built. The tolerances are nice. When it clicks in there, it is solid. It does not move around. And where it has this tightening here, it actually holds it against that real nice. So I don't see that being a problem. So here's your spool, and it's got a carrier bearing there. And on this side, under the tension knob, it's got a bearing in there, but it's plastic. And the hole inside of it is a lot bigger than this. So I could see changing that would help a lot. But like I said, this is just the unboxing, so I'm not going to get into it too crazy. So you're not going to have a centrifugal brake on this. It's magnet. So you can actually test this here. Now you can have that in there, and it will spin. Turn that brake on, and it moves the magnet in on this, on those plates, this ring here. So it just moves it closer to it, and just by turning that on a little bit, it's already doing something. It's already stopping it. I've only turned it on to 5, so you know it works. Very interested in trying this. Can't wait to see what this is like. Very light spool. After the video, I will put some pictures up of all the close-ups of all this, nice macro shots, so you can see what the stuff looks like. So, I'll give you some information on this. This is the 7:1:1 gear ratio. The reel weighs in at 8 ounces. 227 grams, but I will put it on the scale and put a picture of that so you can see. Now this has got the UT drag, and the drag is very smooth. It's very smooth. I don't feel no catch, no nothing. It just feels real nice. This has got infinite anti-reverse. It's instant. When I go to back that up, there's no gap. It's got the dual stopper, and when they say dual stopper, what they mean is inside here, if I was to take this apart and show you, there's an arm in there where it's got like a hook, and it hooks onto a gear that's on the back that's got square notches in it. And it's used for two different purposes. One, to engage the reel when you click it like that. The other one is for the extra stopper that's in there. It's a hook. Now, if you were to try to spin this backwards, you got your anti-reverse bearing, your roller bearing, which is an anti-reverse, it's one way, and then you got that hook. So if that anti-reverse was to slip, you get the catch from the hook finger. So that's what they mean when they say dual stopper. Now this has a machined aluminum spool, wiffle spool. It has 7 ball bearings, so it has 7 ball bearings and then one roller bearing. It's got the magnetic anti-backlash control, which is a Magforce braking system that I showed you. And that's basically it. That's pretty much all the information on it. The reel feels really nice in my hand. It's got a nice little contour here. that when you palm that, everything fits perfect right in your hand. And your thumb fits right on that. It just feels really, really good. Also, this will, if you were going to be using monoline, this will hold 14 pounds, 120 yards. 16 pound, 100 yards. Now, if you're going to be using braid, this will hold 40 pounds, 140 yards. 55 pound, 105 yards. All right, guys, that's just the unboxing. The Daiwa Lexa 100 HSL. Thanks for watching, guys.
The number you have dialed is not in service at this time.